As state lawmakers continue their debate over how much support to give the state's film industry, local officials announced their backing for a grant program rather than tax credits. City and county officials show off maps and plans for how New Hanover County and the city of Wilmington should grow over the next 25 years. New Hanover County prepares for a commemoration of the 50th anniversary of the start of the Vietnam War. And who needs Fashion Week in Paris when you have haute couture right here in River City? Those stories and more next on New Hanover County in the News. Hello and thank you for joining us for this March edition of In the News, a deeper dive into the current happenings in and around New Hanover County. I'm your host, Mark Boyer. As the North Carolina General Assembly meets to discuss two bills increasing the state's film incentives, local officials are throwing their support behind the current grant program rather than reviving the 25% tax credit that was eliminated last year. In a show of solidarity, local political and business leaders met at Screen Gem Studio in February to announce their backing of an increase in the current film incentive grants. Leaders want to send a message to lawmakers that in order for the industry to revive its reputation as a filming location, more funding is needed for the program.
The film and television industry in Wilmington is unified in supporting the efforts of our local legislative delegation to expand and improve the film grant program created by the General Assembly last year. The Wilmington Regional Film Commission, EUE Screen Gem Studios, the City of Wilmington, and New Hanover County are working in partnership with our local legislative delegation from this region to ensure that the film and television industry remains a viable industry in our region and continues to support the thousands of jobs in this regional economy.
We said last year that if the credit went away, that we would see business drop dramatically here, and it has. We have about a 70% drop in inquiries. We've only had three inquiries about productions in this community in 2015, where last year we were probably about 15, maybe a little bit more than that. $170 million was spent here in 2014. We're probably estimating for this year between $40 to $50 million. And we already know that we have our neighbors and our friends and our citizens that are moving to South Carolina and Georgia to obtain work.
There is no way we're closing. We've weathered storms like this, not just here, but in other states where we own facilities. We've got two great clients here right now, and we have no intention of closing, and we will weather this storm, and we're going to move ahead. We're going to get this thing done.
Enhancing the film incentive is a vital part of the Chamber's legislative agenda. Our 1,000 business members understand that saving this and enhancing this incentive is doing more than just keeping the crew working. We know that's important. We're so happy to have the vital, vibrant, excellent crew that we have here. But we have other members of the film industry, as Billy's alluded to, and the small businesses and the businesses around this community. Those guys that open their doors every day to sell wood or drapery or auto rentals or hotel rooms to the film industry. So we see our job as working with legislators across the street that don't have the intimate knowledge that we do, convincing them, showing them the economic impact it's having in communities in terms of keeping jobs beyond the film industry specific viable.
In his state budget proposal, Governor Pat McCrory has offered up only $10 million in grants, but companion bills filed in the House and Senate would increase that amount to $60 million. In 2013, the last year for which audit records are available, the state paid $61 million in tax rebates to productions that spent more than $240 million in the state. In the meantime, a new voice is being heard, the voice of small business owners who wants state leaders to know the film incentive is actually a small business incentive, the only small business incentive the state has ever passed. The new organization, Small Business for Film, is working to show legislators that the film incentive generates jobs and revenue throughout the state, giving small businesses the opportunity to thrive. The statewide group was established in response to concerns that legislators do not realize the impact the film and television industry has on small businesses based in North Carolina, and is working to raise awareness about the issue. Small Business for Film says without a new incentive package, small businesses are losing revenue and being forced to lay off employees. The group is made up of several hundred retailers, sign makers, restaurants and hotels, and other businesses that have benefited from past movie and TV productions. Business owners throughout the state are encouraging other small businesses to join the organization at smallbusinessforfilm.com. And later in this broadcast, New Hanover County Commission Vice Chair Beth Dawson talks to the head of the Wilmington Regional Film Commission on the impact our area has seen from the growth and decline of production. New maps and associated documents from New Hanover County and the City of Wilmington show how the county and city should be developed over the next 25 years. Each map shows different features to be considered for positive growth, such as the location of new streets, shopping centers, parks, and bus lines. Officials with both jurisdictions say the population of New Hanover County, including Wilmington, is expected to increase by 56% by the year 2040. That's nearly double the rate of growth for North Carolina as a whole. Vacant buildable land is scarce, especially in Wilmington, where only about 13% of the city's total land remains available for development. During a public open house on March 11th, the public was invited to review the maps, ask questions, and provide input. New Hanover County planning staff also presented their draft land use map, giving residents the opportunity to see how the city and county can coordinate future development and how residents may be affected. The year 2015 marks the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War, and New Hanover County will be a national partner in commemorating the valor of an entire generation who served in the jungles of Southeast Asia. As a grateful nation and community, we will be honoring the 58,000 American patriots whose names are etched in granite and the 1,600 service members who remain missing in action in a solemn observance in April. The observance will honor all veterans of all wars in which the United States military fought. A section of New Hanover County's Humacrae Park will be rededicated on Thursday, April 23rd. Two screenings of the film To Heal a Nation follows on Friday the 24th. Saturday the 25th, we'll see concerts at Greenfield Lake Amphitheater and a Veterans Appreciation Banquet at the Coastline Convention Center. It all wraps up with a Sunday morning breakfast on board the USS North Carolina Memorial. You can register to attend any or all of these events by going to this website. New Hanover County is a partner in a national program to honor and give thanks to those who gave the ultimate sacrifice, and to the families who still await the return of those still missing. New Hanover County TV also has a week of special programming planned to memorialize those who answered our nation's call. Is your medicine cabinet filled with expired prescriptions or other medication you no longer use? How should you dispose of them? Health department officials say there's a good reason why you should ask those questions. Our health reporter, Angela Clinton, brings us details.
Medicines play an important part in the treatment of many conditions and diseases. But when they are no longer needed, it is important to dispose of them properly to avoid harm to others.
Well, if you don't dispose of medicines properly, one, they could get into our water supply if you flush them down the toilet. Two, if you throw them out in the trash or leave them unattended, kids or maybe adults, could get a hold of those medicines and could be harmed.
There are some special disposal instructions for you to consider before throwing out unused or expired medications.
Well, the best thing you can do to dispose of medicines is to take them to a permanent pill box that we have two located in the county, or to a drug take back event, a medicine drop. But if you can't do that, the next best thing would be to put them in the garbage, but to put either kitty litter or used coffee grounds on the medicine so people are less likely to, or kids are less likely to get in the medicine and use it. Also, we tell people if they're disposing of their prescription pill bottles to peel off or mark out their personal information.
In 2014, one New Hanover County medication take-back event brought in 751 pounds of controlled and non-controlled medication. Medicine take-back programs are a good way to dispose of expired or unused medicines, but they are typically offered only once or twice a year. Recently, several departments within the county came together to create a more permanent solution.
Well, the Health Department, Sheriff's Department, and Environmental Management got together. Environmental Management was having a problem with people wanting to come to the landfill and dispose of medications, and they're not supposed to do that. They aren't set up to properly incinerate medications or take them back. We have the medicine drops usually 2 to 3 times a year throughout the county, but the other 363 days out of the year, there's no place for people to dispose of their medicines.
The two new permanent drop locations in the area can be found at the New Hanover County Jail and also at the historic courthouse downtown. Reporting for New Hanover County Health Department, I'm Angela Clinton.
You can visit the New Hanover County Health Department's website for more information. And what becomes of old books and magazines that are no longer in use? Well, creative teenagers from the area were prompted by the New Hanover County Library to come up with some interesting designs in wearable fashions. Just take a look at some of the creations being strutted down the runway at the Northeast Branch Library. A panel of judges scored each design on creativity, functionality, style, and of course, modeling. Fashion Week in Paris has nothing on this couture. You can judge for yourself by taking a look at the fashion event photos on the New Hanover County Flickr page. And still to come on New Hanover County in the news, Commission Vice Chair Beth Dawson talks economic development and the film industry in depth with Film Commissioner Johnny Griffin. Welcome back to New Hanover County in the news. As North Carolina's General Assembly debates the future of TV and movies, our local and once bustling film business has slowed to a trickle. At present, the CBS series Under the Dome and the long-anticipated movie Bolden are the only two productions left shooting in New Hanover County. Commission Vice Chair Beth Dawson and Wilmington Regional Film Commissioner Johnny Griffin sat down for this in-depth conversation.
Hello, and welcome to EUE Screen Gems Studio, where I am joined today by the Wilmington Regional Film Commission Director, Mr. Johnny Griffin. Thank you for being here, Johnny. It is part of our ongoing conversation regarding New Hanover County's economy while we are here today to continue to discuss the importance of the film industry to New Hanover County and across the state. And today we want to give a little bit of background regarding the role of the Wilmington Regional Film Commission, of which I'm honored to serve as chair this year. And Mr. Griffin, please give us a little bit of history and background as you are the director of the Film Commission, all of the important priorities that we work on for the industry here.
Certainly. Thanks for the opportunity to be here today. The Film Commission, a lot of people don't know what we do. They hear our name from time to time, or they may see it in the press, but they're not really certain as to what our function is. There's several things that we do. Number one, we're a marketing agency and a business recruitment agency. It's just that we're dealing with a very specific industry. Much like any other industry, the reason we do what we do is it creates jobs. These are companies that spend money in the local economy while they're here. And so we want that for the community. But these companies are a little bit unique in how they do business. We're not recruiting a company that's going to put down roots and build a building and then be here for 20, 40, 50 years. We're recruiting a company that's coming in, producing maybe a movie, a television series. During that amount of time, we'll spend tens of millions of dollars in our local community, and we'll employ people who are here in this area that have a specific skill set. But then once that project is over, then that particular film is or TV show is finished, it's done, they move on, and now we're trying to recruit the next one to the area. So, you know, number one, we're trying to recruit those companies here. A big part of that is just continually marketing this area, letting our clients know the benefits of why Wilmington, North Carolina is a place to produce television shows or movies. What do we have here that makes us unique? How do you do business in this community? And for them to know that this is a community that, that understands their industry. And when you get a phone call on a Friday from a producer saying, I'm flying in next week, I want to open an office, and I'm going to spend tens of millions of dollars, that we can make that happen very quickly. That there's not a lot of red tape, and that we tell them it's going to take weeks for this to happen. Very quickly, we're responding to them, we're helping them, we're assisting them, because the quicker we can get them up to do business, then the quicker they're going to spend money in our community and employ our citizens here.
Absolutely. And we have seen the benefit to our economy for well over 30 years here in New Hanover County. And the role of the participants, the members of the Film Commission, the members include representation from New Hanover County, from the City of Wilmington, from the Screen Gems business itself, as well as several other economically involved citizens. So it is a citizen commission, and we are all working independently and together for the recruitment of the business here. Now, as I said, we have had this conversation. We're continuing a conversation because New Hanover County realizes how important this particular industry is to our economy and to the economic prosperity. We have seen millions of dollars of permanent infrastructure invested in our community, for example, here at Screen Gem Studios. And we also have had the involvement for many years of local businesses. So we have definitely seen the economic impact to a well-trained workforce for our small business, and quite frankly, there is going to be an economic impact to the bottom line of the revenue of New Hanover County. Our sales tax revenue that we receive off of sales and production, as well as our room occupancy tax, that's one of the reasons why we are very involved in helping to advocate for this industry. And as such, New Hanover County, along with the City of Wilmington, passed resolutions early in this year to communicate with our local legislators as they are working on behalf of the citizens in Raleigh to support the TV and film industry. Now, local delegations, our legislative advocacy efforts have been ongoing and are currently ongoing. Can you give us an update of what may be happening right now that the General Assembly is in session?
Sure. You know, we had a very successful film incentive program in years prior that in the last 3 years has caused over $500 million to be spent in this community by the industry. In 2015, we saw the implementation of a new grant program. It has not been funded to the level that we would like to allow us to maintain the same level of business. But we're working with the legislature during this session. Just last week, several of our local folks, Ted Davis and Frank Eiler in the House of Representatives, and Michael Lee and Bill Rabin on the Senate side, introduced some language to fund the grant at a higher level to allow production to be able to continue here. So, you know, the good signs are that so far the legislature and the governor's office, they do support the industry. They do want to see the industry thrive. I think it's just trying to determine what the best vehicle is to make that happen, to determine how to implement that kind of a program. So we're seeing support. We've just got to work with them to sort of fine-tune that, get them to understand the business a little bit better and how we can craft the incentive so we'll be able to maintain those historic levels of production that we've seen in the last few years.
Absolutely, and it's extremely important for the members of the Film Commission, which, by the way, was started by a group of local citizens here involved in the economy in 1993, I believe.
Right.
And it was the city and the county and the chamber and business leaders who recognized the economic impact that this industry could have on New Hanover County. So, along those lines, your county commissioners and your city council members have been working hard to with legislative advocacy. As a matter of fact, New Hanover County was very successful in getting the film industry and an overarching economic development program of priorities onto the North Carolina Association of County Commissioners Legislative Priorities Agenda. So we are talking to our colleagues across the state, as I know you are as well, and we all need to speak with a unified voice when we talk to our legislators and let them know how important we feel this is to our economy, that we know is. We've had just locally over $170 million in spending. We have 1,500 local jobs, qualified professionals who call Southeastern North Carolina home and have chosen to live here and raise their families, and they are buying homes and educating their children and want to stay here, and we'd like to keep them here in New Hanover County as well. So what can our local citizens do as far as reaching out to our legislators and letting them know what is so important, especially in our businesses who see that impact so tremendously?
You know, one of the best things they can do is just to let their local legislators know that they do value the industry, that they do support the industry. Our legislators here have always been very supportive and have worked very hard for us. And it's important for them to know that their efforts are not unnoticed, and that people are proud of what they're doing and appreciate what they're doing to try and keep this industry here. As far as the business community goes, they may want to go to a website called smallbusinessforfilm.com. And this is a new effort that's been started statewide, actually. And as we speak today, there's over 600 members across the state. It doesn't cost anything to join. It's basically a website where you go, and if your business is somehow impacted by the film industry, if you do business with the industry or support them in some way, then you go to this website and just register your business. You just sign up, and basically what it's showing is that this is another company. It asks for some information such as, you know, how many jobs your company has. And what we're finding is that, you know, there are many, many, many small businesses that are on this site that you would not expect to have anything to do with the film industry whatsoever. They're not companies that rent lights and equipment or trucks and trailers or anything that is very unique to the film industry. But it's a florist that does business with the film industry, or a landscaping company, a steel manufacturing company, a swimming pool maintenance company, all sorts of different companies out there that do business with the film industry. And some of these are companies that do small amounts of business, several thousand dollars. Some of these are companies that are doing hundreds of thousands or millions of dollars with the film industry every year. And so you really start to see the impact throughout the community and realize that when the film industry comes to town, it's really impacting a lot of businesses throughout the whole community and the region.
Absolutely, and that is what our legislators across the state need to continue to hear, because this is not an industry where a production company comes in and just does their particular production and then leaves, but it impacts the local citizens. It impacts our tax base. I spoke to a business owner just yesterday about the impact of the sale of plywood and building materials. It was a building materials company that told me that the film production company spent more than $400,000 in their business. Now that is directly to their bottom line. That encourages them to employ more folks. It actually really impacts the sales tax revenue, again coming back to New Hanover County, depending upon the revenue streams that we have identified, and so it is very important. So I would continue to encourage, and perhaps we can put on our website as well the smallbusinessforfilm.com link so that folks can go on there and realize how they can be active in this advocacy for the growth of our industry through decisions that our legislators may make. Now, another initiative of the Regional Film Commission is for you to participate in marketing efforts, and I know that you have just returned from a marketing event with your colleagues across the state. Can you bring us up to date on the success of that?
Sure. You know, there's a lot of different things we do to promote the region. Our clients are primarily in Los Angeles, and there are a lot of different events throughout the year that give us an opportunity to try and present ourselves to them or to be in front of them and have an audience with them. And so I actually just returned this week from Los Angeles from a trade show that we go to every year where, in this case, there were 125 other film commissions from around the world. There's about 300 all total, but at this event, there were 125 of us that were there, about 45 being film commissions from foreign countries. And we were all there to spend 3 days in Los Angeles, and this gives our clients, studio executives, producers, production managers, location managers, it gives them an opportunity to come and see us all in one place and conduct business for a few days. And so to be there in that venue with all of those folks and to see film commissions there that are competing with us on a daily basis, and in the same room, not only were there, you know, city and state film commissions from around the country, but you also had film commissions from Korea, China, Fiji, Spain, Portugal, all sorts of different countries that are all trying to recruit this industry. They see the value of it. They see the jobs that it creates. They see the potential tourism impacts that are generated from projects that shoot in their particular regions. And so to see that there for a few days really starts to bring home the point of the competition that we do have. And again, most folks don't ever see that, and they don't know who we're competing with or that there is actual competition for this industry. But it's like any other industry. People want it. People see the benefits of it. And so to spend 3 days there, you actually see the competition and realize how tough it is in trying to get the business. There are other events that we attend. We partnered with the State Film Office. We do a lot of marketing efforts with them. And even though we are competing against other parts of the state from time to time on projects, I would say more than not, we're working together with them on projects because of different locations that we may have throughout the state. So at this particular trade show when we were in Los Angeles, we had the State Film Commission there. We also had film commissions from Charlotte and the Piedmont Triad area. And we were all there promoting the banner of North Carolina. We also did an event earlier this year at the Sundance Film Festival. We partnered with the State Film Office for a reception there to meet filmmakers and to spend time with filmmakers. This week, the State Film Office as well is at the South by Southwest Film Festival. So a lot of times we may not be able to attend some of these events due to the cost or due to conflicting things that may be going on, but the state certainly attends these events, and when they're there, we're providing materials to them. We're partnering with them in some of these marketing efforts, so we still have a presence there, and we're still being sort of introduced while they're there at these different events.
Well, thank you so much for all of your efforts, and I hope our citizens will understand the efforts that their elected officials and local leaders are the efforts that we are undertaking to continue to work for the economic prosperity of New Hanover County. We know the uniqueness of southeastern North Carolina and the state of North Carolina. Now we just need to let everyone else know and continue to work toward the building of our economy through this very important industry that we support. So thank you so much for being with us today, and we will continue our conversation and stay in touch, and hope we'll have you back again to bring us some more updates. So thank you.
Great. Thank you. Appreciate the opportunity. We'll be right back.
For more up-to-the-minute information, follow us on Facebook and Twitter. And that's going to do it for this edition of New Hanover County in the News. Join us again next month to find out what's happening in and around your county. Until then, I'm Mark Boyer. Thanks for watching.